Everybody, this is Dawn from Dare to Dream Romance with my third video and my third mini album. And this one is a Father's Day chipboard album. And I'm making it for my 21-month-old grandson as a gift for him to present to his father on Father's Day this year. So hopefully he will like it. I had fun making it. I did just put this ribbon on just a second ago, and I like it, but I don't think Dad is going to like it. I don't think he's going to think that's masculine, so I'm going to probably remove the ribbon, but I just have it up here for the video. And all of the pages have been painted. The chipboard has been painted with Sierra Brown acrylic paint. All of the pages have been edged, and all of the openings have eyelets. On the front cover, I used Tis the Season Cricut cartridge to cut the lettering. And I cut each letter three times to make it look like chipboard. And then here I have a little metal embellishment from Studio G Collection, which I got at Michael's, two brads as well. And then I used I made a faux ribbon out of the paper collection. And then this butterfly here I got actually from a six-pack of earrings that I got from the Dollar Tree. And when I saw it, I said, oh, I could use that in the scrapbook. And it had butterflies and roses, I believe. So it was like three set of earrings. So I just took out the rings and the French wire for the earring hook, and going to use all of those as embellishment and scrapbook. And I thought that added a nice little texture to the front cover. Then on the inside, the first two pages, what I have here is I used the Lucky Labels cartridge, Lacy Labels cartridge, excuse me, and cut the die cut in half. And this says all you need is love, and this says hand in hand, and I just, you know, stamped and inked, embossed it, excuse me, heat embossed it. And I got the stamps from Big Lots, and then I just added a couple button breads to the corners and to the pockets. And over here I just made two photo mats and held together by a brad again, and then cardstock on the back so he can journal and put small photos here. Here I made two tags, and on these two tags I just used some ribbon as a pull, and on the back is cardstock. And my coworker gave me a wonderful idea. She said, you should let your grandson stick his hand in paint and put his handprints on the back. So that's what I'm going to do, one for each hand. I think that's a neat memory for Dad to have of his son at 21 months old, his hand shape. Hopefully it won't be too messy, because you know how to get a 21-month-old to put his hand in paint and not get it everywhere would be amazing. So hopefully it won't be too messed up, but it still will be a cute memory. Then on the next page, I just did a photo mat and cut Dad out on Tis the Season cartridge as well. And then this is also up so that the picture can slide behind the D. And just use some buttons and a little twine on that one. This one has the cross shape for extra real estate, so just untie that. And these are 4x4, so you have five additional slots, 4x4s, to add photos. So nice size photos to give you some extra real estate in a small album like this. So I think that's a neat way to get that, and I'll tie that again in a second. Cut that out on my Elegant Edges cartridge and just added some breads, and then I just faux stitched around the edging as well. Then over here I made a little pocket, and I was inspired by Creations by Christy video. I think it's called One Page Mini Pocket with Tags. And I'm just holding it together with a little paper clip. And it creates four sections, two are top loading and two side loading. But I was talking as I was gluing the wrong section, so all of mine became top loading. And anyway, I just put some simple tags in here, nothing fancy, with just some pulls on it. So just, you know, he can journal on it, put small photos on it. This is just the insert from there. The words "for you" came from my new Arrivals cartridge that you can cut out for a tag. Then on this page, Elegant Edges, same photo mat. I just added some breads there. And then on the last page, I made a pocket from the new Arrivals cartridge. And this is just being held here with a little paper clip. This is a grommet and some twine. The word "love" comes from new Arrival cartridge as well. And that's that insert as well. So here, I just used some die cuts that I had from, I'm not even sure what collection, it was just a bag of alphabets. And I faux stitched around them to just give it a little dimension. And then this was one of those bags at Michael in the dollar bin of all those different chipboard shapes. This in craft stock. And so what I did was I just inked it with some clear ink and some gold embossing powder and heat set it. And then inside of here, I just use some the same button brads that I use on the second page to make a tie to hold this together. And I just put a tag in here that he can put some photos and put memorabilia from different events like tickets and stuff, because he's already taken him to the rodeo. He's taken him to the air show. So little things like that from those events he takes him to, he can save that in the pocket or add photos. And then on the back, I just left it plain. So I just want to say thanks, guys, for watching. I appreciate your time and your comments and your feedback. And again, if anybody knows how to correct this and show me what I'm doing wrong to get this to appear the correct orientation, again, I'm on a MacBook Pro, let me know. But anyway, thanks for watching and keep crafting and being creative, because you guys give me wonderful ideas. Have a wonderful Father's Day. God bless.